You can't skip this guy.
Game show.
You can't skip this.
What's up, everybody? Enough. Is this sound spam again? I thought I had my my thing off. Is it better? Is it better now? Is it echoing again? How is it echoing? Sorry about that, guys. Why is it echoing? Hello. I think it's okay now. Okay, all right, cool. What's up, Boogie, Venable, Extreme? Yeah, because every time I start a new stream, it changes the game I'm playing from game development to whatever. So, yeah, but it was so weird because I thought I had my sound off so it wouldn't be all echo chambery. I don't know. Is the camera wrong? Looks okay. Of the game? Oh, you mean the title? The title? Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. So, yeah, it does zoom better now, and I'm just about to get it to work with stickiness. So, I'm trying to simplify the way the camera works, too, in addition to making it better as far as visually. So, now that it zooms in perfectly, see that? But then, as soon as it gets all the way zoomed in, it lets go of the zoomed in position. So, there's a problem there. I want it to stick. I want the camera to actually stick on wherever it gets zoomed in to. Yeah, it's mostly code day today. Mostly code. Just coding, simplifying code, making things better. I got this new thing which can print the number, the tick number, and the camera pause really nicely, too. So, this is what I need to look at. So it gets to 25, it zooms in all the way. It's got a nice zoom on here. Then all of a sudden it resets the camera pause. What's up, Arcane? So that's the first goal, right? Is to get this stickiness to work. It's supposed to stay the lens. Not here, move camera, but up here. This is going to be a nice simplification once this is working. So this is how it works. It's every time it ticks the game, it calls the animate method. And the animate method either resets itself if there's no other effects running, or it uses the existing camera pause. So that's what it should allow it to stick, right? It uses the existing camera pause. What game engine? Are you asking what game engine this is? This is Cocos 2DX that I'm using. Let me get you that. So, okay, the first goal is to get that to work. I'm just texting a friend back. Ooh, nice. It's a mountain I'm going to climb. Ooh. All right. The first thing I want to know then is if it's not updating the camera. I still want it to print out where the current camera is. Yeah, yep, I have an iPhone. Nice, Extreme. What are you making, man? I got the 4S. Right, so I want to see there if it keeps the existing camera position. So the whole point of this, right, is to get the camera to stick when it gets down to that zoomed up level. But as you can tell, it's already looking way better than it did with that zoom in. It's perfectly crisp, clean. Zoom in, no junky pixels whatsoever. Okay, yeah, so it moves the camera pause and then it does one last move and then it keeps it. So it's supposed to not do that one. If that was like that, it would, if it didn't do this, it would keep the camera position that it's supposed to be at. Wonder if I actually So it runs this effect. As soon as it's finished with the effect, wait, what gets called first? Either the tick or the flux. Or I mean the flux or the in the animate, first is called the flux and then is the lens. So if the flux ends, it's zoom. Actually, the flux is gonna know that it's done before the lens knows it's done. All right. So the flux animate is going to automatically call the on transition end. Once the alpha's up. But that's a little bit. Oh, yeah, so we'll get flux phase now that once we get to that point. Ah, okay, so it's moving the camera one tick, one single animation tick before that ends. So how would we get the. Wait a minute. I want to create a really simple way for the camera to stick. I don't want this to be a problem in the future. Yes. Oh man, I'm getting these sweet pictures of these mountains. Oh. Wow. I didn't even know they had an engine. That's pretty awesome if it can actually do Xbox One and PlayStation 4. It's crazy that Autodesk would be making a game engine. Cool, man. Well, good luck with that. And feel free to share when you have some screenshots and stuff. Feel free to share about your game here. Post links and stuff. That's fine. Okay, so I need this camera pause to stick at the end, but be really easy. Not be kind of like a. See, one way I could solve this would be to make this effect last a little bit longer if I just added 0.02 or 0.03 or some other magic number to the end of the lens effect, it would keep its camera position one more tick, I think. No, that might not actually work. In fact, it might actually be resetting it before. Okay, so what is the best way to step through this? It's kind of a little tricky thing to figure out. We get to this nice point. Let's log out if we no longer have any effects. Hey, what's up, Lighter Thief? Yeah. Yep, I do, yep. Let's mention when these lens effects are empty. So, Lighter Thief, check us out. The game is looking way better on a zoom. I'm just trying to get it to stick now. I got it sticky last night. I was getting it working, but then I tried this new little method, which should be easier in the long run, a lot better design. But so check out, the actual zoom will look good, and then it'll all of a sudden pop back to the first distance, so it doesn't look that great. But it does look great on the way for the zoom in. So there, that whole 0.6 seconds right there was actually looking good now. Yeah, iterate to the tick. Could be. I could try that. Good call. That's what I'll do next if this doesn't reveal anything here. Lens effects empty now. It's getting that a lot. Wow. Wait, where is this? Oh, that's the beginning. Here we go. We got a good position. Lens effect is empty now. And then it moves it. This might be the problem. Yeah. What's up, Blood? How so? What you mean? What you mean by a more clean solution? You mean to iterating? This probably isn't as clean, right? Good point. All these awesome pictures. All right. Well, so that's the problem. And the lens gets effect the lens effects are empty. So this is where we need to set the sticky camera right here. So we can start the cam pause with V3F unit Z. And then if the effect size is less than or equal to zero, then we can reset the camera pause. If the cam pause is still unit Z. Perhaps I am not understanding this completely. Let me think about that. Let's see if this even works though. Yeah, nice, that worked. Perfect. Nice. So there's one problem where the particles from the light beams get stuck. That's the only thing that's bugging me now. But that looked really good. That looks so good. Let's see it again. Seeing that smooth zoom, it's really nice. Yeah, this is pretty nice. Yes. Okay, so let's see if I can gain a little bit more understanding of this situation and why this did work. So that I don't freaking mess this up later. I'm not exactly sure what's wrong with those particles. I don't know why they start out that way. What's up, PETA? Yo, PETA. Check us out, man. You just joined. Let me show you this new smooth zoom. I'm only going to show the beginning, but I'm going to try and figure out why this actually worked the second time. So here's the new zoom. So like perfectly smooth. All the pixels look exactly as they're supposed to. And yeah, and then it zooms back out. Everything's good. So I'm loving this. Oh, you're just asking. Oh, okay. No, Extreme's not a bot. This is a person. He's a guy making a game with this Stingray engine. No, sorry, man. I don't need to check out that link. I'm good. Unless you are really a bot, are you somebody that works for this company? Just wondering, because you keep on mentioning this link. All right, so yeah, we start off with the unit Z, we run all the effects. In fact, this should be a separate function, apply screen effects. In fact, I think I made that a function. Okay, man, cool. No worries. I was just wondering because you kept posting the same link over. Animate effects, that's what we want to do. Additive cam pause. I'm glad I already made this function. Now, let's move this into its own method. This will be a little cleaner. Animate effects. This all runs and adds to a cam pause. Don't let Jib hear you. Uh, Yeah. Oh, it needs the delta. One more thing. So the double delta. Double delta. Double it down. Double delta. Yeah. I'm on this crazy kick today because I'm doing everything differently. I know it's kind of weird, right? But I think every once in a while you kind of need to do everything differently. So today I'm trying to identify all the habits that I normally have and do them differently. Maybe just even a little bit differently, you know? It's really freshened up my day. I'll tell you, I feel good today. Freaking awesome. It's nice to get out of your habits and to think fresh, you know? So there, that runs the effects in a separate function. So it's a little cleaner, this animate method. And now, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and delete all this other bull hockey. Whoops. This other stuff that I greened out. I think this reset camera is no longer necessary. Slav. All right, man. Mine's not broken. Is yours broken? Yeah, right? I know, it's been weird lately. Twitch is like, some emotes aren't working. Oh, I need to freaking get the Franker face thing because I submitted Jib as an emote. Can I do that on the stream without breaking the stream? Can I install Franker face or whatever that is? Let me see. Oh, let's just check. This could be fun, right? Franker faces. Download for Safari. Doing it. I'm doing it right now, guys. Oh, we could have Jib in a moment. Are you sure you want to install Franker faces? Yes. Enable it. Okay, does this. Let me see. Okay, let's see. I think I might have. Do I have to refresh this window? And how. What is it? I think we're just supposed to type Jib. It probably doesn't work right now. It has to be a capital J, I think. Let me try to refresh this window. Whoa. Whoa now. Whoa. So it should just be. Oh, I think it. Wait, look at this. What's this thing? Jib. Oh, it doesn't work. Yeah, better TV. What's this one? Oh, wait. This channel has no emoticons. Screw you, man. I swear I turned them in already. Emoticons. My emoticons. Jib, there he is. Look. See, I did it. I told you I did it. Add to selected channel. Yes. What? Here. Add selected channel. Did it work? Make public? I need to make it public. Maybe that's it, huh? We're trying to get Jib to be an actual emoticon right now. Publish. Let's see. Okay, so I marked it as public now. Think I might have to refresh. Me try refresh again. Oh, what? Maybe I have to. Do I have to wait like 24 hours or 24 minutes or something? Oh, it's rejected. Thanks, Arcane. What'd they reject Jib for? Really? Why is it? It doesn't say why it's rejected though. You're right there. Click on it. Ah, please choose an emote name that is not identical to the character or item being represented. For example, the emote name Pikachu would be rejected, but these would be accepted. How about if I just call it WizJib? This is a really important thing, right? We got to get this down, right? WizJib? WizJib. All right. We'll name everything Wiz. We'll start it with Wiz. Like if we make a stoned Wiz, it'll be Wiz stoned. Wiz stone, Wiz jib. Okay. All right. So I think I have to resubmit it or something. This is way more important than game development. Wait. Edit? Is there a way to edit this? Or maybe I just have to, I don't think I can edit it. Okay, I'll just resubmit it. A sub button. Let's see. Wait, what's this thing though? Oh yeah, let's just replace. There we go. Awesome! You've already read these guidelines! Congratulations! Trim transparent borders on upload image. No. Jib 1x, 2x, 4x. Continue the next step. Yeah, I think I gotta resubmit. What's up, Azimuth? We're making a jib freaking emote. So, like, next time, you need the Franker face thing, though. You need this extension at Frankerface. Frankerfaces.com. Alright, so this time it's gonna be WizJib. WizJib. Here's the notes. Whoops. Never mind. We don't need notes this time. I don't know freaking notes, man. Check it to make it public from the start, yes. Add to my channel, yes. Review, go. Please, all right. WizJib replaces jib, yes. That's what it looked like on a dark background. This is what it looked like on a light background. You've elected to make these emoticons public. That means anyone can add them to their own channels. Yes, that's fine. Okay, there, they're in the approvals queue. I don't know how long we have to wait for that. Yeah, nah, we were talking about this the other day, like, and we were thinking like Wiz, everything should be Wiz, like Wiz. I don't know, you know, start with Wiz. Cause it's kind of, people are more familiar with that, I think. Can you play BC Warrior in the game? There might actually be a BC Warrior in the game. All right, let's check this out. Let's see if it, where it's at in the approval. Yeah, this might take up to 24 hours, I think. A real person has to go and check this. Make sure it's not a cock or something. All right, great. We'll just let this go. Maybe tomorrow we'll have an emoticon for Jib, and we can add more later. WizJib, yeah. Wheeze, you want it to be Wheeze? Yeah, WizWiz. WizWiz will be the Wiz emote. JibWiz? Whoa, check this out. Frankerface gives you all these other options too. Let's play a game called Banabot. Done. I'm kicking ass at that game. Okay, for people that just joined the stream, I'm working on the second day of working on the camera. It's been taking a long time to kind of refactor a lot of this code, but now it's all pretty much done. So check it out. The zoom looks way smoother. Because it's zooming after it renders to the FBO, the frame buffer object. So now I'm just working on getting that camera it already sticks. I just want to take a look at, yeah. Take a look at this. Yeah, this is what I wanted to see right here. It zooms in, right? This is the zoom in phase. It's zooming. Wait. Here's the zoom in phase. See how the camera is getting lower and lower. This last number is getting lower and lower and lower. It's zooming in more and more. And then it switches to the next phase, and then it goes and keeps the camera. Actually, no, before it switches, it starts keeping that camera phase. Or that it sticks with that camera depth and everything. And then continues that on to the next thing. So really it's much easier to use the lens now. You just came for the mode. I'm wondering if I still need this code though. Reset camera. Right now I got it commented out. The game's working fine. But I think I'm just going to keep this for a minute. I'm not exactly sure how to think about that. So the next thing I want to do is I'm kind of on this quest to make the game easier to debug. So next time I have to go through like the beta phase or whatever, I don't want it to be as stressful. It was kind of stressful last time. So like things like this where I can automatically turn on debug mode while I'm inside the game. This is really cool. The next thing I want to do is be able to I want to see in the top left, I want to see the current tick, and in the top right, I want to see the current camera depth. And also, I want the Y, this key I'm pressing here, I'm pressing the Y key to toggle this on and off. I want this to toggle on first without all the text, and then I press it again and it has all the text. And then, a third time, it just basically increases the verbosity level until it's done. Ugh. Well, these are a lot of ones. There's so many in here. FFC. This is a pretty cool extension. You want the camera to glitch out? Yes, Blood, for sure. Please tell me any great debugging ideas. And your idea to add in a pause key was really awesome, but I did it a little bit different in this game as I did a slow motion. So I can go down into like if I want to see in slow motion the player swinging the sword or whatever, I can go change the time scale. The sound effects are off at this point, but it really helps, especially like this. I can see the orange box is the hit box where you actually are affecting the enemies. No, extreme, it won't actually do that. If I write a glitch effect, the glitch effect during the duration of the glitch effect, it won't reset the camera. So I could create a glitch effect, and all it's got to do is run for a fraction of a second. So it's already good to go for that. Yeah, this is very much kind of stuff that should be done from the start. I agree. Totally agree. Yeah? What's that? What's that? And I'm going to start going ahead and adding in the debug for the tick and all that. Yeah, so it'll be easy to do that. Area. Yeah. Let's add a debug method into area so we can set debug text and all that. How will the camera be fixed after it glitches? After, like I just said, after it fix does the effect, it resets the camera. But that's inside the effect. Oh, I get you, Extreme. So let me show you a little bit more about how these actually work. So here's how an effect works. It runs for the duration that it's being set for. For example, the zoom effect. It runs for a certain duration, right? And every time it runs the animate method, it ticks down its timer. But when its timer is done, it knows that it should reset anything that needs to reset. See how this one, when the lens zoom is done, it resets the camera position? So that's how the glitch effect would work. The glitch would run for a certain amount of time, and it's whenever the glitch effect is done, then it would reset the camera so that when the outside thing does its own camera reset, it works off of the camera pause that this got reset here. Nice. Dude, there's so many crazy ones here. Did you change your name somehow? Or how'd you get this stab across your name? That's crazy. Crazy, man. Okay, debug method to see the current tick. I'll call it from inside lens animate. Right on. Okay, so cool. So when you press a certain button, you save out your game state somewhere. Ah, and from this moment, you start recording the input of each frame. Uh-huh. Until you press the button again. From that moment, you reset the game state to the save state and feed the saved input. Awesome. Cool idea, man. Yeah. Cool. Really good idea, man. Whoa. Do I like visual scripting? I don't know. I haven't tried it. Yeah. You like that? Marza likes that too. Awesome. All right, so we'll make a static method that it's kind of like it's similar to these methods, like setting the cactuses, showing the HUD, and all that. Set we'll call this set tick label. Set tick label and set camera label. Camera. Nice. That actually means that can be a totally self-contained method. Really good. So where we draw, here we go, these kind of methods. Remove item, set item image. Wait, this might just be related to items. No, that's fine. This is a good place for it. All right, so we'll make a little label. This will be a self-contained method. Set tick label. Yeah, totally. Animation bugs, movement bugs, yeah. Uh-huh. Oh. What's that? Welcome to the stream, KX. Set tick label. So inside this little self-contained method or whatever, we'll have a label, static label pointer. If the label is null, then we can create their label we're going to use to output here. So label equals kit label. Yeah, extreme. There's already two bosses. There's going to be nine total. Nice. Vlad, good to hear, man. Yeah, extreme. Let me show you a couple pictures because I'm not really in a state where I can show you in the game just now, but let me show you the images from the alpha version. Where's that boss? Here, so there's one of the bosses. He's the drop the boss. He's really big. And the lightning you're seeing there is from the player. The player has a, can get a lightning sword, which shoots enemies and stuff. So the node for this is going to be area scene. Font file, K font, small. String. An empty string at first. Position is going to be based on the win size. No, wait, no. This should be the buffer size. No, wait, actually the win size. Yeah. Get instance, get win size. So X is something really small, like 2. Win size the height minus something. Minus 2. But we'll give a margin for that actually. Margin equals 2. Anchor back to 0, 1, Z above everything. Actually, all we need to get above is the area layer, so that should do. Nice one, Akuma. What's that? Add some abilities for the bosses that makes the boss special. Like a level 1 boss to an level 9 boss. Yeah, they're already at, they do. Yeah, every boss is going to be special, and some bosses will actually be based on the dungeon you're fighting in, which they're so you like the dungeon you're fighting in will have a certain item which allows you to beat that boss or expose the boss's weak spot or something like that. You know, there's going to be a lot of unique bosses. No, right? Not lame, man. Not lame. Yeah, this is Xcode. That's it. We just created the label. We're good. Now label set string stir. Okay, let's see if we got a tick label already. Lens. And if game get bool setting, set this tick label up with tick description. Hope this works. Yeah, Xcode's free. Yeah, it's totally free. What's up, the Fool's Duty? How's the game coming along? Yeah, it's going great. Still on schedule? No. Oh, bot, ban finger. Man, they changed my ban keys here with this Spriker faces. Oh wow, Halo 5 comes out tonight? Right on. Yeah, the fake boss. You gotta have the fake boss. Yes, thank you, bud. Plus 10. Yeah, nice. Okay, we got a tick now on the top left. Great. That's what I wanted to see. Right? Like you can barely read it because it's a tiny little font, but it's funny too seeing it. What, wait, if I go slow motion, it should slow down that tick timer a lot. So now we're down to 0.1x. Yeah, look at that. Now it's starting to go slower. Even slower now. Boop, 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 boop. A tick is 0.05 seconds. So that 0.1 you're seeing there through 0.9, that little ticker in the top left, that's counting from 0 to 50 milliseconds when it goes from 0 to 1. So, oh no, look at this. Oh, I forgot about these. So if I kill the game with the draw debug on, I need to do some other stuff so it doesn't crash. Yeah. Yeah, there already is crafting. Yeah, well, a couple weeks to a couple months. I'm not sure. I'm not sure. We'll see though. Make Minecraft What's up, Grim Gary? No, Akuma, it's just rounding. Yeah. It multiplies the every time I do slower, it multiplies it by 60%. Or actually the phi ratio, but yeah. Hey, what's up, Ben and Barney? I haven't seen you in a minute, man. Oh no, I think I ruined
T
your
of
chat
murder in the
window.
first degree.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
Oh man. Oh no, I ruined it and I don't know how to watch this again. How do I get this window back? Damn it. It's the key to crypt. Oh, I did this last frame or last stream. I did that same little move. Lost my chat window. Whoa, man! Franker faces changes everything. Stream. I did that thing. Okay, so there's something I do to keep things from crashing. Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. So everything. Yeah, I thought backspace would be it too, but it doesn't work. I pressed backspace and it didn't work. Does it? That's very good. I'm glad the laptop audio is better now. Yeah, if anybody's just like, you're like, what? Why does it sound better? It's because I'm using a new software called Gameshow, which. The best part so far is it keeps my lips in sync with my voice, so it doesn't sound like I'm freaking weird or Milli Vanilli or whatever. I think I can live with it crashing if it in debug mode. yeah, was I? I might have been. I just probably was on a text box, huh? What's up, Kibi the Beast? The game's going great. I'm working on this little feature right now. Where I'll have better debug info. So let's do the next thing. Set camera label. I want to just log out the camera's position. So that would be camera position dot desk. And I need to do a similar method to this one. So we'll have a static label as well for the camera that will automatically get created whenever you turn on debug mode. So it's all self-contained. It's a nice little method. Win size, margin. Let's turn these margins down a little bit, huh? We create another label. This time we want to put it in the top right, so that's going to be 1, 1, and also win size dot width minus margin. And just set a string. Okay, we should be ready to try this. All right, see you, man. Huh? Is it offline again? Already? It looks fine. Sorry. A little sensitive. This isn't open broadcaster anymore. I shouldn't be worried so much about the software. Oh yeah, so turn on debug. There's our camera pause. 001. The only thing I don't like is that it's setting precision width on those. I want to see that without. True. What's up, Xbox Taco? So what is this thing? You can actually just like look through. Catbagween. Panico-chan. These are pretty cool, right? Dang, set width is kind of something built in there. I mean, I guess I could at least turn the width down a bit. Well, let's see what it looks like. How far did you get in creating wise? What? What are you talking about? That's right, we don't. Oh, I ruined it. Oh, man. I tried to control C, control V, but all I did was paste code. Oh, I'm so bad. Oh, 1,000 shames on me. 1,000 shames on me. There, that's what it would look like. That's okay. I like it. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is make it so at first I press this key and there's no text for all these entities and stuff. It takes verbosity levels. It'll toggle the verbosity, so it'll be like 0, 1, 2. I do. I felt really bad. Whoa. Teal it? What you mean teal it, Asmerus? Oh, you mean I should make this colored or something? All right, the next thing is to, instead of using draw debug as a bool, we'll start using it as an integer so we can increase the nut, like the level and all that. Steal it? Oh, he's trying to say steal it. Is there an undo feature in Xcode? Yeah, totally is, man. Undo. Ah. Really? What's wrong with this? Why is this? Oh, there's no get in setting? There should be. Let's make a get in setting. And I'm noticing that my game is running kind of, it's like slowing down my computer with game show running, you know. So I need to put my max FPS to like 45 or so. Oh, that's another thing that should be up there in the top left is the frames per second. Oh, also we're going to want to set int setting. Yeah, that's how I was thinking of it. So return 0 there, get int there. Should be a set int for this one. Good. Thanks, super fresh. Blood, thanks for letting me know. There's no problem, really. And I mean, it's sucks, but, you know. Twitch is twitchy. Wow, it means rocket? Crazy. Boogie. Boogie, it's so funny. So there we go, now we got it cycling through 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. And we're always in debug mode. It's greater than 0 there. Oh, and one last thing. We'll make it so when we call this render system set debug, we want to also clear, set the tick label to be empty, and also the camera label to be empty. And then we also need to make sure these methods can smartly handle that. So if it's an empty string, if stir.size, set the label of it. Oh, this should be just every single time this is called. Start size greater than 0. There. There. So now it's a smarter label, smarter method. Hello, the Elite Gamer. Sorry, man. I don't have any bots. Yeah. Is this a Elite Gamer? Are you human? Or are you just trying to play a song or whatever? This looks like some command for playing a song on another stream maybe or something. Please let us know if you're human, though. Right. Okay, wait, one more thing. We got to keep on checking all these other points for draw debug. Okay, that's cycling it. This is a grabbing is debug. Seems pretty weird to be doing that there. What's up, PMC? Welcome to stream. I'm not even sure what that does. Facts. I'm so unsure what that does. Let's comment it out. See what it does. Health system animate. Here's one. So I wanted to show the entity's health only if this setting is above 1. And then the same thing for, this is if it's greater than 0. We always want to see these collision sprites if debug is on. Same thing here for the attack system. This is just showing the attack system's rectangles. Academic paper, cool. Learning Pi game, nice. Ah, this is the most important one of all. This one, I only want to be greater than or equal to 2 or greater than 1. Yeah, just greater than 1. I only want to see the moods if it's greater than 1. And also this one here is behavior sequence. Okay, if in setting for this, it's greater than 1. And here. Oh, there is? Oh, Jayless. Oh, that might be a problem. Wait, is it a problem? What Wiz pre-words is he using? Is there a link to that? What's this one? Set bool setting? Oh, it should be set int setting. Sure, val tree can be initialized. Oh no, it does need a string. So we'll do, I'll put the value, it's already an int. There. So we can call it ss.stir here. Otherwise, sib equals val. Now sib equals stirring my brew. Wizrobe, okay. That's cool. We don't need to worry about that one. Wizard Woof. Where's the okay, Wiz Mute. Wiz G J He. Good game. Heart, Gawi, Bling. I think we're okay. I'm not gonna wanna use any of those. I think we'll be okay. That's kind of a cool one though. Wizrobe. What? Oh, maybe I have to add it to this stream. Add this to my stream. It's so good. Same with the Wiz hat. And the Final Fantasy Wizard too. Yeah, we got him. Let's see if it worked. I gotta refresh again? Yes! Is there Zelda? Dude, we gotta search for all Zelda. But the old school Zelda. We want like some. I want some Link, man. Is there some Link? Look at this Link. Yeah, ZG Triforce. Definitely adding that one. Tell me there's Link. Yeah, we got some Links. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Link, old school Link. Link champ. Yeah, thanks. Got him. Link. What else? Any good ones? I gotta remember that. Link champ and ZG Triforce. They're dope. Whoops. Oh. What's that? What's this indies versus gamers thing? I like these old, I like these newer ones, but I'd rather have the old school ones. All right, cool. We just got Link Champ and ZG Triforce. Let me refresh the stream here for this. Quick pixel doodles. Nice. Yeah, the link should be done, but I think I have to refresh mine here. Nice doodles. As always. Lighter Thief is an amazing artist. Check us out, guys. Lighter Thief's doodles. He just doodled this up. Yes, Boogie. Boogie. Oh, that's freaking awesome. Good call, J-List. Okay, let's see how this worked out with the whole int setting. So turn on debug mode. Yeah, great. I didn't want to see any text. Press it again, we've got text. Press it one more time, everything turns off. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, of course, man. Oh, these might need to be retained. Let's retain these. Might just be those that are crashing it. Oh, is that what it is? Oh, nice. Cool. All right, so maybe Jib will pop up sometime soon. Cool, thanks, Jayliss. You are Indie and you versus against Markiplier. Nice. PewDiePie? Oh, it's already finished, though? Damn, I missed it, huh? But the game's not ready for that yet. You called it Indie versus Gamer? Maybe I'll prepare for this for next year. Oh, is this a game jam, though? Because this isn't really a game jam friendly type game. This is a full length game. Unless they're talking about doing a game jam where you just bring whatever you have and just work on it for a weekend or whatever. Oh, right. Did I call him wrong again? I know I don't. I don't pronounce anything like anybody else. No matter how I try. Ludumdare. I know I always have to force myself to say Ludumdare. I have to force myself to say Gradient. It's so hard for me still. Gradient. You can't see him? Yeah, you need Franker faces. Franker faces. In the future, they're supported no more. All right, let's see if that retain made it so it doesn't crash. Yeah, PewDiePie, right? PewDiePie. I always call him Poo Poo Die. I don't know why. Oh, still getting a crash on exit, but that's okay. It's not that important. But we should, once we turn it off, it shouldn't be crashing. Still crash. Oh, wait. Maybe the actual... it's the label for... Oh, yeah, and the render component has its own label. Set label. Maybe this needs to be label... Retain. It's Pew. Oh, it's Pew. PewDiePie? Pew. Oh. I feel like such an idiot again, but it's okay. Still crashing? None of those retains, man, are working. PewDiePie. You called it PewDiePie. PewDiePie? Is it PewDiePie? I'm getting PewDiePie and PewDiePie. Ah, here we go. PewDiePie. My name. PewDiePie, got it. PewDiePie. Really? Yeah, really. We just proved it. Thanks, PMC. PewDiePie. So what's more important? Game development or PewDiePie? Hmm? I got a question for y'all. Sorry. I know, I'm such a jackass, right? Oh yeah, this one, I'm not thinking that smart anyways. Game dev, 10 of 10. PewDiePie. Does he stream? Yeah, he has a stream, right? Doesn't he have a stream? I think he does. Totally the biggest YouTuber, yeah. Isn't he? Is he the biggest? He probably is, huh? Okay, next up on the list, I'm going to keep on finishing the Flux. The Flux now works in a different way where it's simpler. It doesn't have to deal with this the camera position every time. Because now that responsibility is all inside Lens. Much better. So I'm going to keep on working on wherever it has using name or new camera pause. We're not going to need that anymore. So phase zoom out. Let's start testing. Well, no, I don't really need to check. Wait, zoom out. Yeah, zoom out's going to need a push effect from that to one. That's already got it. Cool. That should work. But let's test it. Yeah, 40 million subs, right? Yeah, do you have a Mac, man? All right. So how can we test the zoom out? I think actually the refill phase uses phase zoom out. Yeah, we already checked that one. Okay, that one's good. New camera pause. Phase walk two. This one should have a different setup as well. Walking to the sword. This is going to be an easy one to test because you need to test out the sword first. We'll set up a camera destination point. And this takes V3Fs, so it's best to use a V3F here. Just pass in V3F unit Z, CamZest. Zoom out. Zoom out. Sweet J-List? Hell yeah. Working on a maze gen algorithm? I like this, dude. I like how you turned it into a GIF. It's mesmerizing. I love to watch maze generator algorithms. Have you seen, you should talk to Grim Gary. Grim Gary's working on his own world generator that's looking really dope. You still here, Grim Gary? Mesmerizing, man. I can watch that all day.
PewDiePie!
Wow. He's in South Park? No way. He's that famous? Good for him. Ooh. Game of life, man. It's the game of life, right? Did you use the Game of Life to make the first one? Or what's this called? Is this officially called the Game of Life? Isn't it called the Game of Life? Right? Yeah, it'd be nice if I had a set method for these, so I didn't have to construct. Oh, okay. All right, right, right. Okay. Cool, good to know. Nice. Game of Life, second one. First one was Aldous Border. I haven't heard of that one. Because it did look different to how... I have a game generator, or a maze generator in here, which does the overworld. Uniform spanning trees. Any tree that connects all the vertexes in a graph. Isn't that just basically a graph then? A uniform spanning tree is one chosen randomly and with equal probability among all the possible spanning trees. Interesting. Nice, you modified it a bit, right on. What you want? A link to what? Oh, a link to these? Yeah. True, right? That's why he's on South Park. Oh, interesting how it can sometimes go back on territory it's already been on. Interesting. This the maze generator algorithm, the one I'm using, I shouldn't say mine. It's just the one I'm using I found on the internet. It doesn't ever backtrack. It never ever goes back over territory it's already been on. Just how frustrating it can be to watch. Yeah, see? Wow. Let's run this one. Yeah, look at that. It does backtrack a lot. Wow. But I'm probably not reading all this. I should check this out later on. Stop. Well, I'm going to check this out in detail later. Link to Xcode? Just Google it, man. Wow, I didn't know he's a millionaire. Good for him. Oh, yeah. Yeah, something you changed. Crazy. Google it, man. You got it, dude. Just Google Xcode. Okay. Kit V2F. V3F. Here's one. We need a set method. It's cool. Let's get that compiling. What? Really? I didn't know about that. What was that site? Imageify? What should I do? Headphones. That's great, dude. This is the best website ever. Oh, dude, blood, high five, man. Really, I've got to do. You always do your Google searches that way? Always? Why not, man? Oh, it's L. It's L-M-N-L-M-G-T-F-Y. Great website. Dude, how am I supposed to remember that, though? I guess I'll put it on my desktop and remind myself later. Hopefully I get in the habit of using it, because that's awesome. Yeah, true, right? They are. They're more profitable. There's been, since when? Like 2000 something, right? Was it 12? Was it after the 10s where they surpassed movies and music? Oh, let me Google that for you. Oh, thanks, Blood. Right, duh. Let me Google that for you. Yeah, yeah, cool. Got it. Nice. That's awesome. So awesome. Okay, knocking out this other convenience method. Ugh. 2010, was it? Yeah. It was around there. But that's pretty amazing to know. And it's kind of cool to, you can kind of almost draw some similarities between the movie industry and the games industry. I mean, they're different. They're definitely different. But there you can see some similar, like, tendencies in those two. They're both entertainment, you know, right? So they do have some similarities in how the two businesses trend sort of over time. It's almost like games are like 20 years behind how movies used to be, you know, like in the whatever. But also things have changed a lot with the internet and all that. So, yeah. All right. So now we can use this new method right here. Camdesk.set. Banhammer. Is there anything else I should know about here in this new Frankerphases thing? Set alias. Whisper. Message. Ignore. Ban. Unban. Op. You can unban here. That's pretty good to know. Purge.
What's up, Annie?
How you doing?
Look, all right, you don't have to be. Purge. What's this whole purge 5-minute thing here? Timeout user for 300 seconds. Well, what's this? Something logout user? Is that what it says? Timeout user. No. We don't want to time out any users or ban anybody. Except for these assholes. Freaking bots. Bots. Do we have to have bots? Is it Twitch? Here's a conspiracy theory of the day. Is it Twitch that's unleashing all these bots on us? Are they making money from this? Dun, 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 dun. Camdesk. Yeah, timeout user for 1 sec. Yeah. Yeah, to have your own official emoticons, but we're using Franker faces right now. So they're, I don't know if you were here when we were doing this, but yeah, Franker faces. And then you can do anything we've added. So I've got Jib as an icon. He'll soon be added. But for now, there's a few different ones we can do, like Link Champ. You probably don't see those, though, on here. Yes. Oh, there we go. Cool. So we did all the zoom ins now. So let's test them out. Let's test out. Wait. We got this right? Link, lens zoom. This is a zoom walk to. Yeah. Okay. This should still work. Really? It's the first stream you ever saw? Wow, PMC, I'm so honored, man. So honored. It's so cool. Yeah, zoom in works. Beautiful. Oh, man, we're well on the way to getting this old system out of the way. Let's test out the picking up the sword now. Oh, you gotta have a space, man. Space between those. So we'll turn off the sword. Take away the sword. Put the player in the sword room. Wow, really? First ever. Dude, that's so amazing. Well, I got no music on right now. That's why it's not doing any music. Yeah, it worked. Cool. We got zoom in, zoom out, so still look good. We got this whole different debug mode we can get into. Second level of debug mode we get into. Back to normal. First level. Oh, I want frames per second there in the top left. Forgot about that. Nice. Wow. I'm so honored, you guys. You were so amazed by the chat window. Yeah, maybe they should. Frames per second, I need to actually calculate that a little bit different. The tick knows how to calculate that. So we'll do, nice, thanks, man. Oh no, man. What are you going to get back to it or what? Wilk. Yeah, I heard a lot about Wilk. So he disappeared? Damn. Wilk. Wilk. Where'd you go? What's up, Overcaster? It's going great, man. I'm working on some cool little debug stuff that's going to make the game a lot easier to develop. Later on, this will be very, very helpful. So if fmod, the uptime, what does it add to the uptime? Uptime plus equals frame time. That's not what I mean. The art's frustrating you. Oh man. Well, what do you want to do? Do you want to go back to the drawing board and try and become a better artist? Which is totally possible. Keep that in mind. Or would you rather not even focus on the art? What's your plan, man? Oh. Some of them, yeah. This so far I haven't got to that point where I'm ready for the character designs for the NPCs. So yeah, it's not really up to them at this point. It's more being ready for me to be ready for that. So yeah, it'll come at some point. There'll be some cool NPCs, the man, pig, bear, and all that. So we'll just plus the frames per second. And I guess we do need a last. Oh, we have last update time. But that's not what we really need. Once we know we've gotten past the second. Yeah, we need an FPS timer. All right, see you, Extreme. Have a good night, man. All right. Maybe Vlad, maybe here's a suggestion to think about. Maybe instead of trying to force yourself like just to become a better artist right now, because you don't have the time right now to really do it, maybe just spend like, you know, a good 5 minutes a day or so watching people's speed art. Like, speed game art. Let's get some videos. I don't know if this is the right thing to watch. But you know what I mean? There might be some good stuff. You can do some speed. It depends on your style too. Like I would do speed pixel art, but you might want to do speed vector art. So just by watching speed art like this, you know, where you're looking at someone's screen, you're watching how they would create this art, you can learn a lot. And it only takes you 5 minutes to watch their video. And what it does is it subconsciously puts techniques in your brain for art. So you're not actually learning actively, but you are kind of learning subconsciously, you know? This might be something where you get to be a better artist just by watching other people. This is how I learned. I spent a whole year just watching people make pixel art and other types of digital painting. Not really vector art like this, but basically just painting. And then when I finally did, you know, start making art, it was really easy. Okay, cool, man. All right, well, whatever you do, man, I'm rooting for you, and this is looking good. Boing, boing. See, I know you think your art's bad, but I don't think it's bad, man. I think it looks good. Return FPS. Okay, so we got a frames per second timer now as well. FPS timer. Yeah, truly, it's a great place to start, right? Pinterest is a good one. Pixel Joint, yeah, Pixel Joint's good. Okay, so we can increase the FPS timer. And if the FPS timer has exceeded 1.0, we'll subtract it and reset the frame count for this. There, now we got FPS. If you can define the purpose for your graphics and how they complement the gameplay, it can help you, yeah. Zero. I'm 35, I think, right? 35? Yeah, 35. 100 Valerian years. All right, so last step would be to show the frame rate. Set tick label. And we'll get this one last, the sub tick. Get sub tick. That's all we need there. SS.stir. Let's see if that works. We got a nice little clean frame rate, independent of Cocos 2DX's frame rate thing, which is kind of ugly looking for sure. To old people. Yeah, that's what I, yeah, right? Did you have the same feeling there? I don't know. I think once you turn 30, you're like, at least for me, I've started forgetting how old I was, which is awesome. I'm like, yes, I can't remember how old I am anymore. 16, nice. Wee lads. You wee lads. Oh, whoops. No, okay. I forgot. We're not supposed to count up the number. Okay. So, frame rate. We want only to reset it we need like an FPS count. Yeah, I know, right? When I was a teen, we had nothing like this. Yeah, totally, man. Yeah. Yeah, you're quite a busy man. Have you guys seen what his startup does? You should show you, Blood, you should show what you do for work, man. Yeah, lighter thief. To get better at art, sometimes you need to allow yourself to play without a goal in mind. Oh, this is incredible advice right here. The pressure of making something that looks decent for your game may hold you back. Wise. This is so wise. Highlight. I wish I could make this all bold right here and sticky. Can I make your comment sticky forever? I wish there was a way. All right, we go to. We need to tick the frames. The frame count ends in tick. Need like a running FPS count. Yeah, so whenever we tick, we go past the second, we're going to store the last FPS count. There. CS, nice. Yeah, I would agree. I got that feeling right before I started this game. I didn't know if whether I would start this game or not. I was on the fence because it was a big risk. I was like, man, am I really gonna go spend 4 months with no pay? And I'm already in so much debt. 41. That's fine because we've got the maximum set to 60. Wish it didn't crash though. This is freaking labels. The way the labels work in this thing, they crash on exit if you have them still attached to something. Oh yeah, so if I set the frame rate back to 60 maximum, we should get more out of it. Getting 57, 59, 58. Yeah. Wait a minute. If it is the. Wait, does it crash on the first try? Yeah, it's true, right? I am streaming. Yeah. Oh, that's also a problem with the guys talking. Gotta turn that off. Okay, so if I turn off their talking. Right, so we do sword two. Then, and if I only turn on one bit of this, it still crashes. Okay, so it is to do with those two labels. And if I never ever create those labels, thanks, Vlad. Yeah. Nice. Thanks, man. Right on. Yeah, those were those first months of making this game were the hardest. It was like I had to write. That's why I wrote at the top of every file. I'm like, I gotta write courage, because this takes courage. I was like barely scraping by. Thanks to the Kickstarter, though. Thank you all, Kickstarter backers. Nice. I love it, dude. I love Game of Life. I like the one that shoots the guns too and all that. So mesmerizing. You could put this, you could make this into like some procedurally generated art for a game so easily. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Check this out. This is such a rad video. Story, man. Could you guys hear that for real? Wait, let me do that again. I'll watch anything on YouTube.
What are those
Sorry if you
noises?
guys can hear this and it sounds really crazy.
The noises are getting louder. What is that? Is that a face?
So, okay,
What is
I
that?
turned mine off.
Gotcha, bitch!
I'm nervous!
You
The
can't
knight
hear
called her
it.
forth, and she came willingly.
Yeah!
That's probably the part where she died, right? She worked hard at
Oh my
everything.
god!
She was better
Wait a
at
minute.
everything. Yeep, yeep, you.
Hold on. This is big news, you guys. I didn't know that. So then maybe you guys can hear my desktop audio now, clearly. If I just turn on some headphones here. And let's play some straight up audio from from the game or whatever. Oops. Songbringer assets. Yeah, you did hear it. Okay. Let's play song sounds. Yeah, maybe. I hope this works. Yeah, I think you guys can hear that. Dude, this is freaking big news. Really? Are you guys hearing this? Is it clear? Yeah, but this is totally different with this new software I'm using. The old software OBS, this did not work at all. Which, I'm not knocking Open Broadcasters. Actually, it was great for a while. It's just, this software is a lot better. Yeah. Is it good volume levels? Can you hear my voice if I'm talking? Let's see. La 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 la. It looks like I'm louder than this song. Dude, this is awesome. Yeah. Oh my god. I don't have to worry about Soundflower. Yes. Oh. Cool. All right. Let's keep no sound on the game for a minute, or no music for a second. We'll let this play out. Yeah. Oh, it's it's true, right? If I wanted to have this song or whatever, if I had my own uncopyrighted material, I could be playing it in the background, you guys could hear it, and I wouldn't necessarily even have to be hearing it on my end. Yeah, Lighter Thief does amazing art. You should definitely respect everything he has to say. That's why I really wanted to highlight his comment. In fact, I'm going to do that. Where's your comment? This is one of the best advices I think anyone's ever given to artists. Look at this, Lighter Thief. Here, let's immortalize this. I'm immortalizing Lighter Thief right now. Immortalizing Lighter Thief, it's because he's worth it. Yeah, yeah. Lighter Thief. Dunna, dunna. What's this? Alias text? We don't need alias. No aliasing. We're gonna need a bigger font, though. When I told you at the start that the sound was clear, I wanted to mean that I was listening to the desktop audio. That part was clear earlier. Oh. Yo, what's up, Teak? What? Let's play something else. What's this one? Oh, that's old and lame. Boss. Yeah, we're celebrating the fact of having some audio. Let's go, this is a loop. Lighter Thief! Doop 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 doop. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, you like that? It was worth it. It was worth it. Yes, Jonah19, we have music. We freaking out, finally have music. Let me play this Overworld song again. This is a first for this stream. I like this one. Now I gotta make more tracks just so we can have music to listen to. Why does it say looks? Let's just say looks. And I'm immortalizing Lighter Thief's advice right here. This is so amazing. Lighter Thief! games the last month? Mostly alpha version. Yeah, if you make ambient music, please send it to me. If it's copyright friendly. The only thing I worry about is if YouTube's gonna flag it, right? If YouTube flags it as copyrighted music, then I can't play it. Quotes on game startup? Good idea, Jayliss. Good idea. Signed in. I know it's all gray and stuff, and Lighter Thief can make his own way better graphic. That's why I'm making it so gray on purpose, and because I'm not really gonna invest it, you know, the whole stream into making this, but here we go. Lighter Thief sharing this, right? You can hang this on your wall. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. Is this Songbringer? No, it's Patrick, right? Yeah, sometimes they don't. I don't know what it is, but it's, Boogie's been having that problem too. But somehow, some of these emoticons just don't work sometimes. I think it's just Twitch's servers or something. Yes, you've been immortalized. Because that was worth immortalizing for sure. Wait a minute. I wanted to keep these. I wanted to show these too. Yeah. Cool. All right, great. What's next? Let's turn music back on here. So when we play the game. Yeah? Yeah, you guys should be able to hear the game actually now. Right? This should be game audio. Yeah, I hope that was working. Okay, we got that. We got the frame rate we're showing. What tick is current? Camera. Let's do, let's watch the camera. Yes. That's great. I think I might start calling my poop that too. Hey, look, art dump. Art dump. Right? You get a particularly good looking one. Oh, there, it failed. So it should be zooming in and out. Wait. Right? Yeah, that's the best game startup quote ever. Okay, let's pick up the sword. Yeah, it does get rid of everything, huh? So everything else gets zoomed out, but is this really that necessary? I guess so. I guess I want to be able to debug that too. So let's get this working. Yeah. I Lighter Thief. Yeah, there is totally. You got to check out their game. How far along are you guys now? Cruising down the street. Look, a griffin cruising down the street. Oh, there's a guy with a hat. Yeah, exactly. I know. Yeah, I already got that. I got a layer that's not attached to the camera. It should be above the camera, the scene. But it's not. It didn't work. So maybe I'm just putting the... Yeah, see, I put it on the scene. This should work. This should be above the HUD and everything. The camera, when it zooms, when it zooms the camera, it's using this other, it's using this set cam zoom, which loops over area cameras, and area cameras. See, it pushes back the frame buffer object sprite. That's the only camera that it has. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, well. Right? Yeah, scope. But at least you're progressing, man. That's awesome. Oh, we're not high res, right? Let's see, there's a setting for high res. Yeah, high res is zero. Oh man, confusing because HUD sprite is a child of area scene. Oh, at 10,100. The sprite is the area scene child at zero. This is the frame buffer object sprite. So it's a child, there's area scene, that's the top layer. Underneath area scene, there's the frame buffer object layers, right? On top of that should be all the debug info and all that. So that shouldn't be affected by the camera's scale. It should just be able to scale that layer. That's a curiosity. Okay, I'm just going to use an oblique strategy here and ignore it for a second. I'm going to finish something else, and I bet you it'll come to me. It'll come to me. Mm-hmm. Saturating style. I like the way you worded that. So we can go with the rest of the flux things, new camera paws. Get those finished up. Lift sword camera. Yeah. Whoop. Animate. Oh, right. This is where it's shaking the camera. So the best thing to do instead of, okay, the way that this is all working is it's using the lens is solely responsible for modifying the camera. So this could just be called camera, but it's called lens because Coco Studio X has already got the camera namespace. Instead of shaking the camera using this old school method, we need to shake the camera using the new school method, which is to do a lens effect. So we're gonna, when we begin the phase for lifting the sword, we'll trigger a tick, schedule before tick. We'll wait times. Oh, need to make this a better array. Awesome. What's your Tumblr, Overcast? Overcaster? Can we just do this? Times plus equals that? C++ wizard? Nope. What if we went vector double? Nope. What about that? No. I thought that one would have worked. Huh. Yes. Your art dump. Nice, Overcaster. This is sick. I like this one a lot. It's kind of scary, but very cool. I always think these kind of masks are scary, though. That's, it could be exactly what you're going for. This is cool, too. This thing's sweet. I really want to see it animated, whatever this is. Looks like a rad enemy or something. Here we go, some animation. This is crazy. It almost looks like one of those old stoves, you know what I mean? But it's also like an enemy with a top hat and stuff. It's rad. Nice, nice bear. This guy's cool too. That's awesome. Wow. You definitely got some great art here, man. Good job. Is this Sword and Sorcery? Yeah? Rate my boo. I don't even want to look at that right now. But I'll save the link for later. Uh-huh. This is cool. Rad. Dude, I love your art, man. Sweet. So, Overcaster, do you have any GIFs you've done where you show your, how you would create something? Like, do you have a GIF of maybe, like, this guy or whatever, sketching him over time? Like, you know, what you started with, how you added your layers, or whatever you did to create this guy. It'd be sweet to see, like, a GIF of how you do stuff. It would really help, I think, some other people understand how to make art. You know, it's basic stuff, right? How you would go and layer stuff up or sketch it or whatever. But, you know, that's, you don't have to do that kind of stuff. I'm just saying it would be cool. Nice, man. Really like your art. Nice. Yeah, I'm sure you've got, right? You've got some kind of like, you stream it. Nice. There you go. Cool. All right, so we are gonna have to push these back. Anyways, that's fine. Yeah, man. Nice, dude. So it's so cool. I love finding out more about you guys. So we're going to schedule after the first part of this. I think we just have to wait one. And then, yeah. So we need to wait through that much percentage of transition duration. So times zero times transition duration. And after that amount of time, we're going to schedule a lens effect, lens push effect, new what's it called? Oh yeah, lens shake. This is really great, moving all these into being how they should be. You know, this is a much cleaner system to have everything related to the camera in this lens class. So shaking, we need a duration and strength. The duration of this shake is going to be the opposite of all that, I think. Yeah. It runs the whole time. Okay, so we'll get a float duration. Double float, whatever. Duration equals transition duration minus transition duration times zero. And strength. Let's get this thing up to maybe 4, 2, something like that. Strike 2. All right, and now we should be able to comment out all these new camera position sets. These are all about rocking the camera with a little bit of shake and jitter and all that while you're lifting the sword and all that. You know what? This might not look good. I wonder if this will actually look right. There's two ways I could do this. I could actually manually set the camera position from this animate method, and that would still be fine, I guess. Whoa. Oh, yeah, okay. So this shake effect, it ruined the zoom. Okay. Didn't look horrible or anything. If I just had it set so it didn't ruin the camera zoom. See, that brings back this whole issue about whether I should be doing a sticky camera or not. 49 seconds each frame? You mean milliseconds? Oh, whoa. A nonlinear differential equation with 40k by 40k matrices? You do mean seconds. Wow. That's quite a challenge, dude. I'm stoked for you. Yeah. Oh. Crazy, man. What a crazy challenge. right, two solutions to this problem. One, manually set the position, but two, on the other hand, it probably would be expedient to make it so that the lens is truly sticky. So that the lens should, when it zooms in at one time, you know, it zooms in on the camera and all that. Man, I'm getting tired. I think I gotta get going soon. Kinda getting, losing my flow, man, flow energy. Just got the sword. We gotta unget the sword. Mesh faces. Wow. Right, it zooms in, and as soon as that shake kicks in, it zooms the camera back out because it forgets about that it had zoomed in. You know what? I guess what we would do is just make it to the lens. No, see, that would break everything if I did that. Huh. Wow. Okay. There's two paths to go down here. One would be to fix it the way I'm imagining, with just setting the camera manually. Two would be to get this to work so that the the stacked on effects, all these animated effects would work off of a base camera position plus the actual dirty cam. So there would be a base camera position and a camera position. Oh, that's the debate, right? Which way is a better design? Hey, good night, Lighter Thieves. See you, man. So I do gotta get going here soon, but I'm gonna write down my thoughts so I remember what I'm doing here. So there. When I come back to code, this is what I'll think about. Yeah, sounds like it. All right, so we're just gonna wrap up today's stream. What I've been working on the last 2 days is new camera effects. So wait, let me let's do this the wrong way, or the other way I was thinking. So we'll go cam dest v3f cam dest. It's sort of like the, I guess not necessarily the wrong way. We would need to back up the position of the camera too. Cam base is lens, get camera pause, and then Cam dest equals cam base. Yeah, so yeah, I'm gonna get going. But anyways, yeah. I guess I'm not even gonna show the game before I go. So anyways, sorry for the crazy stream today, but we did really realize some crazy cool things. Like I can have audio now. That's awesome. Yeah, this game is called Songbringer, and it's coming out in 2016. So good luck with that, Vlad. I'm sure you'll kick ass, and I want to hear how it goes, man. And we'll see y'all later. Have a good night.